Today, we'll consider how the Pantheon in Rome was constructed, and then delve into the question of who built it and why. Within Roman imperial art, the Colosseum, also known as the Flavian Amphitheater, with its history of bloody spectacles, often gets the most attention. The Pantheon, though, is the building that had far more influence, being the ultimate inspiration behind much domed architecture, including buildings around Portland you might know, such as the Temple Beth Israel in Northwest. The dome is the hallmark feature of the Pantheon, so now let's step inside to take a look. As you can see, the dome, like most of the building, is made from concrete. While today concrete might typify banal modern architecture, to the ancient Romans, on the contrary, it was cutting-edge technology, and we see ingenious Roman architects pushing this material to its limit here. The Pantheon's dome is both the oldest and the largest reinforced concrete dome in the world. It soars to a height of 43.3 meters, or 142 feet, and has the same width, proportioned, therefore, as a perfect sphere. The ancient Roman genius for engineering is evident in crucial details, such as their decision to use progressively lighter concrete aggregate as they cast the layers of the dome's concrete in horizontal bands, so that the bottom layers are made of substantially heavier concrete than those near the top. Square coffers also helped lighten the structural load of the dome and visually articulate the expanse of space capped by the oculus. To create a subtle optical illusion, the coffers become smaller as they ascend, making the dome seem even higher and more imposing, while the oculus allowed a piercing beam of sunlight to illuminate the interior on bright summer days in Rome. It also allowed rain inside, so the building's floor has a drainage system. The floor's richly colored marbles, granites, and porphyry likewise mostly come from the original time the rest of the building was constructed, and the high level of preservation of this building relative to other Roman monuments built around the same time is likely because it was the first of this group to be converted to a Christian church. Unlike, say, the Colosseum, which became a kind of go-to quarry for medieval Romans, the pagan Pantheon was transformed into the Christian Church of St. Mary of the Martyrs in 609 CE, when bones from the catacombs outside of Rome's city walls were brought there for safekeeping. The Pantheon's dome covers a cylindrical drum, and you can see the 8 deep recesses when you look at the plan, now used in a way that reflects their centuries of use as a Christian church. While the interior dome might have seemed startlingly innovative to the Romans who first viewed it, the Pantheon's porch, its public-facing exterior, was reassuringly traditional, with its 16 huge Corinthian columns, with materials imported from faraway places such as Egypt. Yet the inscription on the porch proclaims that Marcus Agrippa, the son-in-law of Emperor Augustus, built it, and that can't be taken at face value. It's just one of the many examples we have of Roman emperors citing predecessors to bolster their own authority, and alludes to an earlier building on the same site. That, though, begs the question, who then was the patron of the Pantheon? Careful research into the brick stamps indicate that it was the Philhellene Emperor Hadrian who built the Pantheon between 118 and 125 CE, and Cassius Dio, the only ancient who wrote about the building, says that Hadrian used it in several distinct ways. Primarily, as its name suggests, the Pantheon was a temple to all the gods. It may have also served as part of the worship of the imperial family, for Roman emperors of this period were deified after death. Thirdly, it may have also sometimes been used as a law court. Given that range of uses, it may have been meant to convey a sense of the permanence and universality of the Roman Empire itself, but that's a matter of debate. Countless architects through today have been inspired by the Pantheon, its beauty as a structure, as well as the amazing technical virtuosity that it represents, has made the Pantheon one of the most important buildings in the Western architectural tradition, a fitting trajectory for a place built to honor every god. It's no surprise then that the Italian Renaissance artist and architect Michelangelo, on viewing the Pantheon over 1300 years after it was built, proclaimed it was of angelic and not human design.